Hi students, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about the second chapter, electric potential and capacitance. First of all, we want to discuss about what is electric potential. Okay, to explain electric potential, we need a charge Q. Okay, we need a charge Q. We already studied that around this charge, electric lines of forces are there. So there will be an electric field around this charge. Okay, now we want to consider a point P in this electric field. Okay, consider a point P in this electric field and it is at a distance r from the charge Q. Okay, the point P is at a distance r from the charge Q. Now, we want to take the second charge. And that charge is unit positive charge and it is placed at infinity. Okay, the second charge is unit positive charge and it is placed at infinity. Okay, now we want to bring this unit positive charge from infinity to the point P. So what we want to do? To bring the unit positive charge from infinity to the point P, we want to do certain amount of work. Why we want to do that work? Because there will be a force of repulsion between this Q charge and plus 1 coulomb of charge. Because both of them are same type of charge. Okay. Both of them are positive. So there will be a force of repulsion. And that repulsive force is in this direction. That is, plus Q charge repels plus 1 coulomb of charge and it is in this direction. So, the directional force is in this direction. Okay. What about the expression for the work then? We know that work then W is equal to vector F dot vector D. Work done is the dot product of force and displacement. Okay. Here, work done to bring this unit positive charge from infinity to the point P. To find out that work done, we want to divide the entire length of the path into small sections. And each section is having a length is equal to dr. Okay. To bring the charge from infinity to the point P, we want to do certain amount of work and to find out the work then we want to divide the entire length of the path into small sections. And what about the small work then? Then small work then W is equal to vector F dot vector dr. Okay. Then total work then is equal to total work then to bring from infinity to the point P is W. W is equal to integral infinity to the point P. The point P is at a distance r from the charge Q. Therefore, infinity to r F dot dr. Okay. Now, we want to remove the dot products. That is infinity to r F dr cos theta. Theta is the angle between F and dr. Then what about angle theta? Force is in this direction. Then what about the direction of displacement? We want to bring from infinity to the point P. Therefore, displacement is just opposite to the force. Okay. Vector dr is in this direction. Then what about the angle between them? Force and distance are opposite to each other. Therefore, that is they are anti-parallel. Okay. Therefore, theta is equal to 180 degree. That's equal to integral infinity to r f dr cos 180. Cos 180 is equal to minus 1. Therefore, we can write work done is equal to infinity minus infinity to integral infinity to r f dr. Okay. Work done W is equal to minus integral infinity to r f dr. This is the work done. And this work is stored as electrostatic potential. Therefore, potential is equal to minus infinity to r f dr. Okay. Now, we want to Right, what about F? We already studied that F is equal to Q into E. E is the electric field which is produced by this charge Q. Then what about this charge Q? This charge Q is plus 1 coulomb. Okay, here the charge Q is plus 1 coulomb. Therefore, plus 1 into E. Then force F is equal to plus 1 into E, that is equal to F is E. Now we want to put E instead of F. Therefore, what about the equation for the potential? That is minus infinity to minus integral infinity to R E dr. Okay. Therefore, what about the expression for the potential? Expression for the potential V is minus integral infinity to R infinity to R E dr. This is the first expression for the electrostatic potential. Okay, then what about the first definition for the electrostatic potential? It is the work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to the point P in the electric field against the electrostatic force of repulsion. Okay, then what about the equation statement for the electrostatic potential? It is the work done. Okay, potential is the work done to bring unit positive charge from infinity to a point in the electric field against the electrostatic force of repulsion, and its equation is V is equal to minus integral infinity to R E dr. Okay. Now we want to find out what about the final expression for the electrostatic potential V. Okay, due to this point charge. Potential due to a point charge. Okay. Once again, we want to write the equation for the potential. V is equal to minus integral infinity to R E dr. Then what's the equation for the electric field? Electric field is produced by this charge Q. Then what about the electric field at the point P due to this charge? We already studied that. What's the equation for electric field? E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q divided by R square. Okay, that's equal to minus infinity to R 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q divided by R square into dr. Okay, what's the next step? We want to take the constants outside. Okay, that is minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 is taken outside integral 1 by R square into dr. Okay, infinity to R. That's equal to minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 into integral infinity to R. 1 by R square is taken as R raised to minus 2 into dr. Okay. Then how can we integrate this? Okay, for this we want to know about the integration rule. What is integral of R raised to n dr? That is equal to R raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. By using this equation, we can write it as minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 into R raised to minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. That's equal to minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 into R raised to minus 1 by minus 1. Okay. After integration, write it in a square bracket, then infinity to R. Negative, negative get cancelled. Therefore, Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 into R raised to minus 1 can be written as 1 by R. Put it in square box. Infinity to R. Now we can apply the upper limit first, then lower limit. Okay, that's equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 into upper limit is applied. Minus, before applying the lower limit, we want to put a negative sign, 1 by infinity. What is 1 by infinity? 1 by infinity is equal to 0. Therefore, the final expression for the potential is q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 into 1 by r. Okay, this is the equation for the electrostatic potential. Okay, this is the second equation for the electrostatic potential. Equation is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q divided by r. This is the first equation. V is equal to minus integral infinity to r e dr. Okay. Now we want to draw a graph connecting V or E, that is potential or electric field versus distance. For this we know that V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q divided by r. From here we can write it as V is directly proportional to 1 by r. Okay. What about the equation for the electric field? E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q divided by r square. Okay. From here, E is directly proportional to 1 by r square. Okay. Now we want to draw a graph. V or E versus distance. Okay. V is directly proportional to 1 by r. Okay, we want to draw an inverse relation graph. So, the graph is like this. V is directly proportional to 1 by r. Now, what about this? E is directly proportional to 1 by r square. Because of the r square term in the denominator, the steepness of the curve increases. Therefore, this is the graphical representation for E versus distance. That is, E is directly proportional to 1 by r square. Okay, this is the graphical representation of V or E versus distance. I think this topic is clear for you. If you like this video, please subscribe and enable the bell button. Thank you.